thanks for tuning into my YouTube channel today. Today I'm going to be talking to you about my book, Enforcing Prayer, and I'm going to be doing a demonstration for you on how to allow the scriptures to navigate your prayers, help you declare what is true for your life, help you to reconcile some things in your life. But before I do that, if this is your first time tuning into my YouTube channel, make sure you click that subscribe button. Take a minute to like it. Leave me a comment. After you watch this demonstration, if you have other passages of scripture that you would like for me to demonstrate for you, leave that in the comments. I would love to do those demonstrations for you. I love to take suggestions. I love the Word of God and the power of the Word of God to really help us come into our fullness, help us be set free from the things that we feel like we're trapped by, things that we feel like we're stuck in, and really help us to walk in the fullness of who we are designed to be. Now, let me talk to you for a moment about the premise of these demonstrations that I'm about to do, and that is that the scriptures are our truths. We have things that were given to us on the cross that are established in our design, yet we have this reality of how we live our lives. So a lot of times when we're reading scriptures, we hear, we learn, we get to see what our fullness could be, what it should be. For example, in James chapter 1, when it says, consider it all joy when you face trials and tribulations. We're learning in that passage of scripture that in the middle of trials and tribulations, I should be considering it joyful. Well, I don't know about you, but I read that passage and I kind of get some information. Sometimes we even feel a little condemnation in that, because the reality is I don't always feel joyful in the midst of my trial and my tribulation. So often what's happening is we're reading scriptures and we're getting this exposure of what our life could be, what it should be, but we don't know how to allow the scriptures to really yank our reality into an alignment with what is true. So this is the passion that I have in my life, is to really teach you not just what your life could be or what it should be, but how do we enforce that in our lives? Hence the books Enforcing You, Enforcing Purpose, and now Enforcing Prayer. So I'm going to be doing demonstration for you today. I'm going to be walking you through Psalm 23. Now I'm going to kind of demonstrate, but I'm also going to kind of teach and train at the same time. For me, the best way to teach and train is actually by demonstration. When I'm meeting with clients, I just don't tell them that this is what your assignment is. I say, well, let's practice what that looks like. Let's go ahead and walk through it together before you leave this room, because I want to make sure that we have a complete understanding of what it looks like. It's kind of like when you were in high school and you would watch your teacher doing algebra and you got information, but unless she actually had you doing it and you walked through it together, you could just look at your math book and you couldn't do the math problem. You needed that demonstration. You needed somebody to come alongside you and to really walk you through that problem. Well, at least I did anyways, because math is not my strong suit. And so I really want you to walk in the fullness of who you are called to be. So the best way that I know to really teach you how to pray prayers that are enforcing truths in your life, that's why I call it enforcing prayer, meaning there are truths that are already established and we want to bring those into existence. So today I'm going to pick, I'm going to read through Psalm 23 and I'm going to demonstrate for you what it would look like to declare. Now, when we're doing, I'm looking to see if I have a mirror here. When we're doing our self-reconciliation, if you have a mirror, I want you to take that mirror and I want you to look at yourself in the mirror. So that will help you understand the difference between a declaration and a self-reconciliation. A declaration is basically saying, okay, I hear what God is saying in the scripture and I'm going to declare it back to God. Yes, I believe you. This is true. This is who you are. This is what you're saying to me. A self-reconciliation is then when I'm going to shift from speaking to God and I'm going to speak to myself and I'm going to declare what is true to myself. So in other words, a lot of times it's easy for me to say, God, you say I'm beautiful. You say I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. It's a whole nother transition, a whole nother step of healing to be able to look at myself in the mirror and say, Lisa, you are beautiful. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. Because God has designed you, you are. And so you see the difference there of how I'm shifting from declaring to God to really self-reconciling places in my heart and my mind where I'm really not into an alignment with what is being said. So this is a very powerful thing. If we can learn to do this on a regular basis, what we are doing is we are faithing it until we become it. So a lot of people are saying, well, I'm speaking it to myself, but I don't really feel it. That's okay, because you and I shouldn't live by feel. We live by faith. Hence my shirt, Faith It Until You Become It, which you can order on my website. So let's talk about Psalm 23. Now I'm gonna kind of try and just get into a space where you don't exist and it's just me and the Lord. So I'm gonna read it, declare it. I will go back and forth to kind of teaching you. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. God, you say you are my shepherd. You say that you lead me, that you watch over me. I declare, God, that you are my shepherd and that you are watching over me, that you are leading me in every step of the way. I shall not want. God, you say that because you are my shepherd, because you fulfill me, that I have no need of any other thing. God, that you fill me with the fullness of satisfaction and contentment. Now, what you just heard was you heard me speak the scriptures, then I declared, God, I believe you. Now I'm going to declare it to myself. Watch. Lisa, God is your shepherd. He is leading you. He is watching over you, and you are content in him. You have no other need. You have no other want except the Holy Spirit in your life. God is leading you, and therefore you are content in the name of Jesus. Now, did I make up something to speak over my life? Let's be honest. We are self-talking to ourselves all day long. So some of you might be watching this and going, ooh, that's super weird. You're talking to yourself all day long. I guarantee you when you're looking in the mirror, you're saying something to yourself. The question is, what are you saying to yourself? Is it in alignment with what God would say to you? If you're looking at yourself saying, ooh, those hips are big. Ooh, you're such a loser. I can't believe you did that. Or just saying those things in your own head, you're not speaking to yourself the way God would speak to you. So I'm just coming into an alignment with what God is saying. I'm not thinking of things to speak to myself. I'm not making up things to pray to God. I'm simply agreeing with him and what he says from the word. Verse 2, he makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Now, I actually read 2 and 3, so let's go back to 2. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. God, I rejoice and I thank you that you cause me to come to a place of stillness and rest. I thank you, God, that you have provided for me the green pasture of your Holy Spirit. I declare, God, that you are my green pasture. You are the stillness that I so desperately need. God, I receive your stillness. I receive the green pastures of your spirit. God, you are my truth in Jesus' name. Now, all I've done is I've declared back to God what he is saying is true for me. Now, I'm going to speak it to myself. Now, let's pretend like I'm in a frenzy or whatever. Lisa, I speak to the frenzy in your life, and I remind you that God is your green pasture. He is wooing you into the stillness of the kingdom. I speak to you, Lisa, and I speak the green pastures of the kingdom, and I speak the stillness of his presence over your life. I speak to chaos. I speak to frenzy. I speak to anything that would cause you to feel ill at ease. And I tell it to be quiet in the name of Jesus. So now I again have done a demonstration of how I've shifted from declaring back to God to really self-reconciling. You even got to see me kind of doing just some deliverance there. I'm speaking to these things. I tell you, you're not true. And so I'm really convincing myself that what God is saying is true, is really true. Because a lot of times we read these things and we kind of nod, but we're not really in alignment with them. So we're like, well, God says he's a green pasture and he's bringing me into still waters. But I'm not living my life that way. I'm living my life like I'm on a roller coaster and I can't seem to find stillness no matter which direction I turn. That may be your reality, but I want you to begin to declare what is true so that you will pull your reality into what is true. The reality is the stillness of the Lord isn't about what's going on around us anyways. It's about what's going on within us. So I might say this, Lisa, I shift your mindset from looking at the things around you, and I shift your mindset to being reminded of the stillness within you. Though there are things that are shaking and quaking around you, you are filled with the peace of God in Jesus' name. Now again, just a demonstration from that same verse. All I've done now is I've prayed through verse 1 and 2 of Psalm 23. Let me move to, He restores my soul. This is a big one. He restores my soul. God, I thank you that you are a God who restores my soul, the fullness of who I am. My mind, my will, my emotion comes into the place of complete restoration. God, that in your presence, my mind, my will, my emotions, the things that I think about, the things that I feel, the way that I make decisions, the choices in my life are restored, are refreshed, are reset by your presence in the name of Jesus Christ. Okay, so I've done the demonstration of the declaration. Let's shift and watch the mirror talk, the self-reconciliation. Lisa, your soul right now in Jesus' name is being restored. I just speak that even as you come into an awareness of his presence, that as you allow his love to just ooze you from the top of your head all the way down to the tips of your toes, that your mind is coming into an alignment with kingdom mindset. Your heart is coming into an alignment with the heart set of the kingdom. I speak to every choice that you make, and I speak that you are coming into the alignment of the kingdom. I speak a refresh, a restoration, and a reset into you right now in the name of Jesus. Now, I might even in that moment kind of just stop and just allow, I might take the authority and say, mind, I shift you, I restore you right now, I break all chaos off of you in the name of Jesus. Heart, I thank you that you are coming into the beating of the Father's heart. And so look at how I'm just really beginning to just take authority over my physical body, over my soul, over my thoughts. That's what it means to take all your thoughts captive and bring them into the obedience of truth. That's what it says in 2 Corinthians. We're going to take those thoughts captive. We're going to take those emotions captive, and we're going to bring them into an alignment with what is true. I've not even gotten through verse 3, y'all. You should become so quick at these. This is what I do every day to really, otherwise I'm going to get my butt kicked by the world. I'm going to get my butt kicked by my own thoughts, by my own emotions, the circumstances around me. I have got to be girded up day after day with what is true, body, soul, and spirit. It says, he leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Look, this is attacking. I don't know which way to go, God. I can't seem to find a path. I don't have an answer. But God, you say, you lead me in a path of righteousness. So I declare right now in the name of Jesus that I'm being led, God, that you're imputing into me holy revelations, that you're giving me direction, that you are guiding me, that you are illuminating the path for your name's sake, that you would be glorified. Father, I'm coming into a right standing with you, into the right path with you, into the most excellent way of living in Jesus' name. So again, I've just declared what is true. Now here's my self-reconciliation. Lisa, I speak to you right now in the name of Jesus, and I declare that God, his Holy Spirit, the Word of God, is illuminating a path that is alluring you down a path of righteousness. That everything you do, every place you go, you will be in the path of righteousness, and God will be glorified in all of your ways, in every path you take, in every step you make, in every connection you have. You are led by the righteousness of Christ, and he is glorified in the name of Jesus Christ. Okay, so just again, a very quick demonstration. Now, I'm trying to give you lots of examples of these. This can look as simple for you as, God, you say that you lead me in a path of righteousness. So I declare, God, that you lead me in a path of righteousness. Lisa, you are led in a path of righteousness. It can look that simple. That's okay. Obviously, I've been doing this for years and I teach it for years. The fact that I'm skilled in this scare you off. Just get started today. Pick a passage of scripture. Take Psalm 23, 1 through 3, the ones I just did. Do those. Do them for yourself. Get adept at them. Just get your foot in the water and starting to not just read scripture, but declare it and reconcile it. Speak it over your life. Declare, enforce what is true in your life. Declare over your heart. Declare over your mind. Declare over your choices. Declare over your body. Speak to yourself what God says is true for you and walk in the fullness of who you are designed to be. Now, I'm going to pause here, and I'm going to pick up in the next episode on and verse 4. So this is just part one of enforcing prayer, working our way through Psalm 23. You're welcome for that. But I'm going to encourage you to get a copy of my book, Enforcing Prayer. Now, I know it's backwards for you. Enforcing Prayer. Now, in this book, it has a verse, the declaration, the self-reconciliation, and then it has a my revelation spot. Why? Because I don't want to do all the work for you. I just want to stimulate a conversation between you and the Holy Spirit where God begins to declare what is true for you through the word. So this is really just to kind of allure you into that path, give you examples so that you can begin to declare what is true for you on a regular basis. All right, so get a copy of my book. Remember, this is you and I working together to really enforce what is true in your life. All right, you guys, don't forget to click like, leave me a comment. I'm gonna go ahead and go through Psalm 23 verses 4-6 in the very next episode. So you're gonna wanna hit that notification bell. I bless you in the name of Jesus to really grasp the power of the Word of God to enforce the fullness of who you are designed to be into your reality. All right, you guys, remember, enforcing purpose, it starts with you.